anybody because I don't think anybody trusts you. That's my personal
opinion. You're so direct.
Not in this house, no. I wish it didn't have to be you, but I feel that it does. I'm sorry.
Wow, I don't feel I've ever seen such a straightforward housemate as him. He's like there's no fluff. There's no
even on his bed, the
bullshit.
Pink fluffy sheets are gone.
It's just real talk, isn't it? Wow. I don't know if that will work forever, though.
No.
You have to blow smoke a bit.
You can't play that, though, can you? Like, you can't...
Fake it. You can't do
anything to stop that. Like, you can't... In the face of it, what can you do?
Well,
apart from listen.
Last week, he went and kissed Chris's ass a little bit, didn't he? And that worked. Oh, you mean for Min? She's fucked.
Yeah, in the face of it.
Oh, yeah, Min is fucked.
You can't argue it.
What do you think of Sheldon putting your favourite up?
This is the power of show ceremony. Rhianne and myself have
hopefully the eviction get cancelled.
Hopefully.
But I've earned the power to
but
be
I don't think it
one of Sheldon's nominations.
That means Min's not one, though.
That was a deduction. I have decided to use the power of veto on myself. I believe that I was nominated.
Why don't you think the eviction's got cancelled?
I just think given the circumstances
but
it will happen.
My life motto goes, get knocked down 7 times, get up 8. And that's exactly what I will be doing moving forward in this game.
Ooh, like a zombie.
Sheldon, since I just vetoed one of your choices
I get knocked
for
down.
Eviction,
get
you
up
now
again.
Need to name a replacement nominee.
Are you alright?
Yeah.
Oh dear.
Just about.
House guests,
Min looks good.
Ooh,
so does Sheldon.
I've spoken to all of you multiple times. As HOH, I just feel like I have to just make the best decision possible with the information that I have. My replacement nominee is Minley.
I knew she weren't long for this world. She's too entertaining. Mm. Weak, Jamar
this
said.
This veto ceremony is now complete.
Jamar should have... Ah, that box! Jamar should have done more to save her.
I
really
have
do.
Been put on the block because my name has been dragged through the mud.
Yeah.
I will wreak havoc.
Yes!
Somebody has been stirring the pot on my behalf.
Vanessa.
And I'm going to figure out who it is. I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, he's gonna evict
that boring cow over Minnie.
No one, because Minnie's a troublemaker.
Yeah.
On the block, and I feel like she's gonna do anything she can to stay in this house.
Mind you, she's got more game of fighting her than Rhianne.
Oh God,
so
I know
maybe
that.
She can talk it around.
Yeah, but sometimes the more you do, the worse it is. If you know what I mean.
Yeah, true. But she's. She's made a few convincing points that have turned people's opinions so far. So
I think
never
she
know.
Needed to do it before she went on the fucking block. Let's watch that coronavirus bit.
Where are we going to find it? YouTube?
Oh, I don't know. It was on Twitter, I think. Oh. Oh, that's right. It's probably on there.
Aired 19th of March. That's today.
Oh.
It's do we not want to watch this?
That's what we just watched.
Min can't keep a secret.
Oh.
I don't think I can watch these things.
Don't
anyway.
Spoilerize me. I'm covering my eyes. Shall I pause this or?
What?
Is that a spoiler?
No, it's fine.
It's alright, listeners. I've got my eyes closed. In case you were worried.
I can't ask her to throw a condom. If it's not.
Shall I pause this?
This is a bit from the other scenery.
I'm going to pause it. Okay, now we've got the exclusive clip from Big Blagger sent to us by Alfie Sheldon, another attractive Sheldon. And it is the housemates being informed about the coronavirus. And this is from tonight's show, not yet seen, although by the time this is uploaded, it will be.
Probably. So Canada decided not to send Arista in a glass capsule.
No, oh, that's
to tell
a shame.
The housemates, which is a shame.
I would have liked that.
Let's see how Aaron Brock handled the situation.
Hey, house guests.
Hey, house guests.
I have some news to give you guys about the outside world.
Oh.
They know that means bad news.
Before you entered sequester, there was a virus in China called the coronavirus, or more accurately, now it's called COVID-19.
Brooke
since
eating an apple.
Sequester, yeah. With us, the virus has continued to spread worldwide.
Wow. Okay.
The World Health Organization declared this an epidemic on
terrifying.
We're following all recommendations laid out by the Canadian government. We have contacted all of your caretakers directly to make sure that all of your families are healthy and that everyone has confirmed that they are healthy.
Oof.
Basically, so you guys know, it started in China, right? And it's worked its way out throughout Europe. The majority of cases are in China, Italy, and Iran.
I have a lot of family in Italy. Can you just ask my mom and make sure everyone's okay there?
Yeah, just said.
Everyone as I can.
Okay.
Sorry. Oh, God.
My parents supposed to be in Italy.
Now she's got something to cry about.
Right now.
They're supposed to be in Italy right now. They're not.
They're not there.
Yeah. Your
parents cancelled
their trip. Yeah, shut up, bitch. God, make it all about us, as usual.
Yeah, sorry, guys. My kids are sick. I'm out of here faster than you can even find.
That's fair enough.
Our families, and like, if they need us or they feel they need us in any way, then that's more important than anything that's going on here.
That's true.
Is there any possibility that this could affect the rest of Big Brother?
Oh!
I can't say what will happen.
Good question.
We're really hopeful not, that it doesn't. We're taking a lot of measures here with our practices and how we do everything.
Oh.
I love you guys.
That's more good. Balls in the mouth then.
There's another and there's real life. Please know that we will give you any further updates. If things escalate, we will share that with you. We want you to be able to make the choices. If someone goes into the pantry, then there's a letter for each of you from home.
That's nice. I felt quite emotional watching that. I don't know why though. I think it's just because they were quiet. Whenever I see someone else cry, I cry quite, unless it's Maddie. I don't know. Just like, imagine not knowing anything about it if you were like in sequester when it proper started. Because if you think about it, when it first started, even like 2 or 3 weeks ago, it was a joke. Causing it, we were laughing about it. Well, I mean, we're still laughing about it now. But if you didn't know anything and then you just hear that, that would be quite frightening.
Yeah.
Don't you think? And it's a pure reaction. That's what you get from Big Brother. A pure, undiluted reaction. Don't you? Yeah, Why are you laughing at me? Because I'm crying.
No, because I like it when you get emotional about like, the true power of Big Brother. It's nice.
Go on, what are your thoughts?
I'm inclined to think that if I was in the position that I probably wouldn't be moved to tears over something, over news like this. No. I don't think. But obviously people have got legitimate fears and concerns about their family members.
You've got to think in there, it's completely amplified. They have no contact with the outside world. The only thing they hear, there's a fucking virus spreading around. I mean, they're not even told them how many people fucking died.
That's true.
You know, this is really serious. This, we've never seen anything like this ever.
No.
So.
Yeah, I think that was probably the best way they could have handled it, really. It does need to be Erin Brock saying, hey guys, I know I was criticizing.
Oh, come on, where's Big Brother? This is Big Brother.
Because even in Big Brother UK, I think at this point they'd break the character. But
yeah, true. That was interesting that Angie said, "What does this mean for the show?"
Because
you would be, I'd be worried. I'm worried as a viewer, so they're going to be worried as players.
Yeah.
Well, aren't you? Because you can't. You're right. You can't rerun it. You can't redo it. In fact, your suggestion was the best one. Take the best people, put them in a series of. Put them in with Ica. Players, see how they feel.
Put them with Ica. You want Gibbs TV? Put them in with Ica. Yeah, I think that was. Do you know what the funny thing
that
is?
That was really good.
We're so like, oh, no outside world contact. But like, that's one of the sort of most gripping moments that Big Brother will probably watch in the next few years.
Yeah.
I think it's a good thing that they told them.
Mm.
And it's also. It probably was good enough to tell them your families are all fine. The letters were probably a bit too far for me.
That's you're cold. You're fucking cold.
They are a bit soft over there.
Nah, I think that's nice to have the letter, because then the letter can say, don't worry, Uncle Blah Blah's fine, and Blah Blah's fine, and we're fine. Carry on playing, keep up the good work, blah, 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 you know. That was powerful, I think. What are you looking at?
I'm trying to see if there's anything from Endemol about Big Brother and the ones they're shutting down.
I wonder if there is a statement or something.
There was on Twitter, there were statements.
Laurie's probably sent it to us if you look in the emails. I'm sure they would keep us informed. Gaz is now on the Endemol Shine Facebook page. Not Facebook.
News.
Web page.
Let's have a look at the Endemol Shine news. Oh,
Oh, Big Brother returns to Greece after a decade away.
Yeah.
Sweet. Not anytime soon, I don't
think. Germany's is also a reboot. It's like a sort of, it's been off for a while. It's a 20th anniversary version.
Isn't the thing with BBUS, like, auditions have been cancelled, but don't that mean the show's been cancelled if auditions have been cancelled?
Possibly, or just delayed.
I don't know. Unless they get oldies back.
How old? Protect yourself from the virus. Enter the Big Brother
God.
House.
Do you think this adds more
gravitas to the eviction process as soon as you're evicting someone into the world of the virus?
Oh my God. Take your chances out there. Boom.
Yeah, bye.
I have to fucking evict them in
Do
a
hazmat. Still want to evict the oldest housemate?
Evict them in a hazmat suit. yeah, not the much is, on the Endemol Shine website.
No, it's not. They don't really know. This may not be the full details they told them, but they won't necessarily know that it's killing off old people.
And no, they won't know.
People with weakened immune systems. Like, but the kids are okay.
Italy is on lockdown. Like, they don't know, like, places on lockdown.
It makes sense. Oh, sorry. It does make sense for Maddie to get emotional if her parents were supposed to be going to Italy.
Of course.
I just criticised her. Shouldn't be the
no,
same.
No, but it is. There was something sort of me-ish about that, wasn't there?
Well, it's Maddie.
Because they did just say, like, all the families are safe, so.
Yeah.
But that was, just watching their faces, it's like, this is real. This is something outside the game. This is something real. Even Taron would have to, like, bat an eyelid at that. You look at the emails now.
I'm trying to find what Big Brother, what the Twitter's, Endemol said on Twitter, but maybe it's a bit long ago. Here you go, Big Brother statement. The health and well-being of Big Brother housemates is our priority.
Unless they didn't. Unhygienic task.
Yeah, unless they're having to pull a ball out of some fish guts.
Yeah, or chipping their tooth on some.
on a prick. All current productions were informed last week that the usual format rules regarding outside news did not apply in this instance, and it was requested that they inform their respective housemates, note the term housemates, of the evolving situation regarding COVID-19. The majority of housemates have already been briefed, and the process will be complete today, 17th of March. Shall I open the inbox?
Yes, please. And don't forget Richard's one, please.
Can you remind the listeners of the email address while I do this?
Yeah, listeners, if you'd like to send us an email, just drop us a line to bbonblastpod@gmail.com and we'll be sure to answer any questions. Keep it sort of 50 to 100 words, ideally.
Mm-hmm.
500 words, absolute max. Anything over that, straight in the bin.
Right, this one's from 7 days ago, so it could be really outdated.
It doesn't matter, just like Richard. Our podcast, perfect. Yeah.
This one's from Richard. It says, hello Lindsay, Gaz, and the king of cameos, aka Mr. Towie.
Are we not at Towie? Because I've been around here the past 2 times.
No, I was on yours last time.
Are we?
Yeah.
Oh.
Been a long time since that bloody cat kept going in and out the door and
oh,
sitting
God,
there like
a gnome. Do you know what, the next night when Jack was around, he was in bed all night.
Been a long time since I emailed, so here we go, and hopefully I won't ramble too long. As I know you'll both be wanting to wind down after recording a long podcast and get stuck into some Prosecco. No, we don't drink after the podcast. Hopefully it's spelled the right way. Anyways, first of all, welcome back as we head into a new decade of Big Brother, and we welcome Australia back to the Big Brother fold.
Yeah, that's nice. We were just talking about that.
Pre-recorded it may be, but it is Big Brother after all, and as a certain supermarket chain says, every little helps.
Yeah, we'll take what we can get.
Especially for us Big Brother fans, as it helps fill that Big Brother UK gap.
Yes.
Have to say, this cast is already winning me over, and in particular Min. She's definitely not afraid to say what she thinks, and has a potentially good social game, lol.
Yeah.
And I reckon she has got a good chance of getting far in the season.
Oh, how Richie. Things can change.
Don't hold your breath, Richie. Hopefully she doesn't overplay, as opinions can change very rapidly.
Oh, God,
the world of Big Brother.
The irony.
As so many housemates and house guests over the years have found out to their cost.
At their peril.
Really enjoyed your first show for this season, and looking forward as always to retweeting them
Aww.
And posting a link to them on a certain forum.
Oh, Digital Spy.
Is it Digital Spy? Or
yeah, Digital Spy. Thank you so much for that. I appreciate that so much. Isn't that cool?
That is cool.
That's wicked.
Thank you. And also promoting them in my little blog.